Hi, now we'll look at adding a custom admin view to a component. We'll make use of cost-benefit projection as our component, and then we'll go to settings, and then we'll go to custom admin views, and we'll see, let's just close that, open it again, and we'll see it has two custom admin views added. Now, it has more switches than the site view because of its implementation being more dynamic. You can choose an icon because in the back end you possibly want to have an icon when you're on that page, on the right of the page. Then you can decide whether this should show in the main menu. Select that the view should show in the main menu. The main menu is the menu that drops down out of Joomla's menu item list, right? And then the dashboard, which is that dashboard we go to every time when we start with a component, that all the icons are shown up. Then the sub menu is the one on the left, which you see when you're in a view. So these are all placements where you can possibly add this custom view. Now, if you remember, the company results, we didn't add to any of the views individually, we added to items. So that's why all of these are set to no. And that means we're targeting an item in a view. And so all we need to do is select the view which we are targeting, which is company. And we say, okay, it has metadata, yes or no. And it has access, yes or no. And that's basically it. To ensure that it targets the correct view is simply by selecting company here. If I close this for a moment and then open that component, I'll show you what has happened with these settings. So here we have that component open. And if I was to open companies over here, you see that it has a button here for company result. Now, if you remember when we set up this custom admin view, we ensured that we are targeting an item ID. And by selecting company, we are saying we are targeting this company's item ID. And that is what makes it work. And then we said we want to see a chart. And so if we look at these little charts is what shows up in the icon itself. We click on it, we see the custom view shows up and that icon shows up next to it, and it all works well. We also see that there is a combined results button showing up here in the toolbar, and that is because combined results, we selected, we want Cox to be the icon, and we said list of records is set to yes and has metadata and has access and also company. And so these selections before is only really necessary when you select main menu and sub menu, because then you want to say before what item you want this menu to be created. Now we've selected dashboard list of records, and because of that it places it in here. And you need to select the records that you want to look at, and then you can click on the combined results, and it'll grab those IDs. And since we are modeling the data in the controller and the model, it gives back to the view these results through the custom implementation we've done. So just a quick refresher, if we go to Component Builder and Custom Admin Views, and we open company results, we see that in the custom button we added the PHP, we also added the button, we explained to Component Builder what kind of buttons we want, and so we said we are targeting a single item. You see those, edit company, go to company. Now those buttons are actually related to going inside of the view. And then if we come out of this, we saw that even in combined results, we also added buttons. But again, those buttons, vCard, companies, go to companies, it corresponds to this controller. And if we go to the view itself, and we'll see that that's not responding to this button, but actually to the buttons inside called companies and edit. That's the buttons you were building in the custom view. Whereas the buttons we are looking at in here is related to opening the custom view itself. So that's just a quick refresher. Same goes with the combined results. The combined results is the button that you are setting up here, whereas the other buttons are once you have combined them and you've clicked combined results, you see that it adds two buttons, dashboard and companies, and those two buttons were set up in the view itself so that you can know and sort of understand what area controls what set of buttons. This area controls the buttons before opening the view, whereas in the view the buttons you're setting up there is for when you have opened the view. Okay, so that is setting up a custom admin view to your component and some of the switches. Obviously, again, if anything is unclear or you're not exactly sure, you can obviously come and undo anything. So simply go change it to what you would think should work and compile the component and go look in the code and see what has been done, and look in the Joomla interface and see what is being displayed and play around with it until you get that which you expected. Just a quick heads up, this ordering before is only compulsory when actually selecting add to main menu or add to sub menu. And if you use those, it means that if you go to your component, you have the icons area, and here in the top you have your main menu items. And once you've opened then you're here on the right, you have sub menu. So this is main menu, this is dash list. The dash list is that one which goes to the top of the components toolbar, and then sub menu is the one here on the side. So if this custom admin view is simply needs to be placed in the sub menu and it lives on its own, it's not related to any other data set, then you can use the sub menu method. If you only want it featured in the main menu, these are all the features that you could set. Whereas the dashboard list record feature helps you to sort of link it to a specific set of data structures like this one does. So you can select these IDs, and when you click on this combine results, the IDs of these selected items get passed to the controller. And if I go back to that quickly, show you that how we use it, combined results, custom button. You basically see that go to companies, it's not in here. So we see we're using the main get called companies data get list query. So let's go look at that data query. I think that's where we'll find the use or the implementation of those IDs. So here we see we are basically reaching into the input object here, and we're getting CID, selected IDs, and we're saying it can be SMD. And then we are exploding it, and we are making sure it's intervals, and we're placing it in IDs. And so this actually gets the value from the post object, and places it into IDs, and here we do some validation to ensure that the person who's trying to access the data actually has the right to do it. And once we've passed that, we basically use those IDs to get the data. So in the filter, we use IDs and check whether all the IDs are in a ID, and that in the code, basically, if we look at the code, it's under models, combined results. We see that it uses our checking method here, and then later here down here, it checks the IDs, puts it in an array, checks that it's an array, then implodes it, and checks whether it's, you know, only gets those IDs. So that's how we filter the data set with the results of the selection. And so that's just a little bit looking into the back end on how to make use of those features. And again, as you can see, it's some custom scripting we added to the dynamic get method to take those IDs and to use them in the way we intend. Now you can ignore them, but here is the way that I've implemented it. If you want to jot that down, pause the video, then copy some of this area here. I think would be the only part that would be useful to your purpose. And then you can use the IDs in your code as you please. And know that this PHP, as you saw in the code, it runs before the get methods. So it basically is a filtering option, as you see there. So the list query starts, then that code we wrote is entered in here, and then the rest of the code, which is built by Component Builder, is being done, and you can use a filter option with whatever you collected up here. Okay, so that's looking into adding custom admin views to Component Builder, and just showing you again the tremendous leverage and design choices you can make in ensuring that your component is dynamic and get sort of breaks out of the mold, so that you can achieve nice complex components right inside Component Builder. Thank you for watching.